With the master's course at Durham, we aim to develop our students in terms of both breadth and depth in relation to an undergraduate course, say. So we try to give you specialist skills, we encourage you to develop those specialist skills and also challenge you to work with great nuance and precision in terms of your research projects, the type of research you do, the types of arguments that you develop. At the same time, we expose you to a range of debates in the particular field that you're working within. So debates in the past that have shaped the discipline, and then also debates that are running currently that you will participate in as a student.
I felt like the course had a fantastic breadth. Even though I did the musicology pathway, I was sort of really attracted by how diverse, how many topics are covered within that year.
In practice, the way this works is that the course is structured for a year if you're full-time, 2 years if you're part-time. And when you do a taught master's at Durham, you choose a particular pathway. We run 5 pathways, music and science, musicology, ethnomusicology, performance, and composition. And with that choice, you will do a particular core module in that pathway. And so that core module in, say, musicology or in performance, that's where you'll be exposed to those range of debates within your field. Then the whole cohort on the taught master's programme will do a module in research methods and resources. And this is where we expose you to a range of different methodologies and tools that you might use across different pathways, and also think through some of the implications of those methodologies. So, for example, we do a session thinking about the way that the internet has changed the research that we do and the ways that perhaps theorizations of that haven't caught up with our practices. We also think about the ethical implications of doing research and the way you might negotiate that as a researcher. And that's also where we think about your communication skills. So we work on presentation skills, we work on your written skills as well. So these are things that will be eminently useful, whether you go into music as a career, whether you go into academia, or whether you do something beyond music for that matter.
I think this is a fantastic programme that they've put together, in that there's core modules which give you the skills to become an academic and to be aware of not just what's going on in your specialism, but also how that relates to things like performance and ethnomusicology.
I think one of the best elements of the course is coming into contact with so many different topics. You feel immersed in the world of music scholarship as it stands in the current time, which I think is really special, because you're looking and you're working with a group of your peers who are also, you know, researching in various fields, and you get swept up in what they're doing and what you're doing, and it's just a really engaging way to learn about how music research is pushing forward and how music education is developing in universities as well.
Alongside those two key modules are then your optional choices, and this is where you can really choose to develop your specialism. So there are optional master's modules within the departments. You also have a choice of the undergraduate modules that we run. You can do master's modules in other departments. You can also do language modules. So if you were a music analyst, for example, you might choose to do a master's module in advanced music analysis to complement the musicology core module. If you're a performer, say you might be a lead singer specialising in German repertoire, in which case you might choose to do a German language module. Or if you were doing the music and science pathway, you might choose to do something in psychology. So that way you're able to develop those specialist skills that I was talking about.
Such diversity helped me to explore my research interest. It is especially useful if you want to pursue a career in academia but had no idea what your research is going to be.
So I took 2 undergraduate modules, one of which gave me the analysis skills that I knew I needed. The other gave me experience in how to deal with music and politics, both of which form fairly fundamental aspects of the research that I like to conduct.
Those taught modules are taught in small groups, so it's very discussion-based. Then when you come to your individual project, that's taught one-to-one, so you get a lot of individual supervision there.
I think mostly what the MA is focused on is building research skills in many different fields and in many different ways through all of the different modules. You really develop a bank of research skills that you can apply to any of the assignments you do, but also any research or study that you go on to do. But also, I think through the seminar-based style of the course, you really learn how to interact with other learners and how to discuss and debate topics effectively. And I think that's been really enriching for me.
So really, the idea is that this Taught Masters program prepares you for a career in academia, maybe, if you wanted to go on to a PhD, for a career in the music business. And a lot of our students go on to work in music in different ways, whether in the publishing industry, whether as performers or composers, or whether in arts administration. But it also prepares you for careers beyond music and academia, because it's really allowed you to develop your critical thinking skills and your communication skills, your capacity to develop sophisticated arguments, and those will be valued in whatever high-level career you choose.